La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Muhammadur Rasulullah. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Millions of years ago, huge animals are called dinosaurs, roamed on Earth. Now there are no dinosaurs. Do you know why? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praises are for Allah. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hal uqdatam bi lisani yafqahu qawli. My dear brothers and sisters, this is Khadija. Hope all of you are fine. It's my pleasure that once again I have been given a chance to deliver and present a short speech from my beloved science teacher on the topic adaptation to environment. So I was talking about why there are no dinosaurs now. Scientists believe that this happened due to sudden change in Earth's climate. In this natural world, a plant or an animal adapts or changes itself to suit its surroundings. This process of changing is called adaptation. Adaptation. The natural home of an animal is called its habitat, and animals can be grouped according to their habitats. Animals are found everywhere on the earth. They are found on highest mountains and in the deepest of the sea. They are also found in deserts or in cool places. Animals live in the wild and even in our homes. They live in air also. The surroundings or the environment in which these animals live and survive is what I only discussed, called habitat. In this short span of time, let me discuss some. Number one. Animals like horses, lions, and camels develop scientific features that help them to survive and live on land. And most of them have legs, which help them to run fast. Some of them have sharp teeth and pointed canines to catch their prey. They have well-developed sex organs, which help them to look for food in dark nights also. Please remember one thing, animals like snakes don't have legs. They have plates or scales that help them to crawl. Polar bears and Arctic foxes live in cold region. They have fur on their bodies to keep them warm. Lizards and frogs sleep several months to protect them from cold. This is called hibernation. Hibernation. Deserty animals have thick skin with low hair, which protects them from the heat of the sun. The all above animals fall in terrestrial animals. Animals. Number two, aquatic animals. These animals live in water. Fish, snails, turtles, and crabs are the best examples of aquatic animals. Such animals have wings or limbs to suit it for swimming in water. Fish and crabs have gills which helps them to breathe in water. Number three, amphibians. These type of animals can live both on land and water. Frogs, toads, and salamanders have limbs which help them for swimming, with moist skin which help them to breathe in water, and lungs which help them to breathe on land. Number four, aerial animals. Animals and insects that fly with the help of their wings are called aerial animals. And bats are the only mammals which can fly. Animals which are the boat shaped with wide body can easily cut through the air. Number 5. Arboreal animals. Some animals spend most of their time on trees, like monkey, tree lizards, flying squirrels and opossums are some arboreal animals. They have claws and broad hips built to support their body while climbing. Monkeys' long curly tail help them to swing from a branch. Hoping this kitty concept of mine will help you to understand the habitats of above discussed animals, insects and mammals, etc. Thank you for not watching me, Tiamanila.